major wheel. And real quick, let me use very quick. The big thing on Okuruma, Ashiguruma, different throws like this, they're talking about the thing that's the axis that you wheel somebody over. You know, Okuruma means, O means major, Guruma, like I said, means wheel. And when I do this, and I like this particular entrance, but Darius could show another way. Your leg is across the upper legs of him, almost at the hip, maybe even the hip area. Okay, so and you'll sweep with that leg. Okay, but that's the axis that he's going to wheel over, that big long leg. It's different, like a Harai Goshi, where you're coming in using more hip. Okay, it's not a hip throw. It's really a lot of leg and throwing here like this. Okay, but you're throwing across his hip, but you're not using your hip as the axis. Okay, now in Ashiguruma, Ashiguruma is his leg or foot wheel. It's more across here, lower. And you're using your foot or your low part of your leg as the axis he wheels over. In this particular case, it's way up here and he's over your leg. You're kind of blocking his upper body with your leg. He's using a lot of hand action to come in and sweep, okay? He's going to show the real basic way to start. And he's also going to show a little side action where it's a little kind of a kinkayotsu, you know, opposite side action and a little back step. Which I like that second way better. Well, let's take a look on the first way, the very basic way. So let's watch here, and I want you to practice. When Derek does this, real quick, you got a good standard grip, kumikata, his foot, come over here. Are you lefty? Very good, right? Yeah. So he wants to step real far over here, see that left foot? That's that cross step, and then he's going to spin and throw like that. Okay, I'll get out of your way. There is Okuruma. He's wheeling him over his long leg across the upper leg area. There you go. Okay, so let's look at that cross step. We've done that cross step in Uchimata and other stuff too, but this cross step's a big one. See that? Now the thing here is on Okuruma, because you're extending your leg so much, it's kind of a deeper cross step. So as you do that, start a little more to your right. Okay, if you're a right. So when he steps across, there you go. That's a quick spin, and there's a cross there. So that's the setup action, that's the footwork. Cross step, that's the very basic way you see in the Kodokan syllabus, okay? So step across, there it is, okay? Now, I like to do this years ago. I kept my leg pretty well extended just because that was a personal preference. And I'd roll them or kind of do a Michael Comey thing with them. If you want to, you're still sweeping, so if you want to use your leg like Derek did, to sweep perfectly okay. But just remember, it's higher across here, and this is the axis he goes over, okay? Now, the other standard one, the other way that I like to get a grip back here, okay? And a sleeve grip. And I like to, if he was, his lead was the left, I'm leading with my right a bit. A little opposite side action, kinkayotsu. All right, now what's going to happen, my back foot steps in, and comes across. It's a real fast action. So that's one you'll see maybe a lot of contest situation. Can you do that? Okay, so see that lead? He's kind of turn around so it's the back view of that. Now watch kind of the back view of how he does. It's a fast wheeling action. There's a lot of hand work there because he's using a lot of this, a lot of good ikite, pulling hand action, guys. So when you're coming across this way, either way, you did your cross step, whatever, but you're coming here and a lot of pull here and that blocks them. It's almost a block and a sweep of one, okay? One more time and good thing. So there you go. Again, I was tall. This is a good tall man technique or a heavyweight technique. When you can get any kind of grip you want up here, but the thing is, I'm leading here with my foot, and when I do my back step, which is the back step here, is yes, yeah, my back step there, and a lot of pull. Okay, so spin and catch. That left hand is really essential because that's what helps you wheel them over your leg. Can you do it one more time?
Keep your hands in front of you all the way through.
Good point. Keep the hands in front of you all the way. See that? Across the mouth guard. But what you don't want to do is get lazy with that pulling hand, guys. That's where a lot of people get in trouble. Don't pull down, keep pulling out. It's very, it's standard judo technique. It's wonderful stuff. It really works no matter what you do. Some little way with the sport. A lot of pull. One more time, each one. So cross step first. There's a nice overrun because it cross higher up here. And then the side step, you're leading kind of same side, same side. There you go. Okay? That's overrun. Do you see the difference between that and Hirai Goshi? Hirai Goshi is more of a hip throw. More of a lot of hip lifting. Here's Hirai Goshi. See that? A lot of hip across there. This was the axis in Hirai Goshi, the hip.
Hirai Goshi is very directional, like forward, backwards, pulling them in, take that back step, and then throwing this way. This one, you have that angle that doesn't really come in with Hirai Goshi.
And that's where there's the fulcrum right there, the thing you wheels over. Okay. Are we good? Let's give that a practice. Let's go. A natural move. Okay, make this. Don't try to pose, because I remember when I was a kid learning this move, we were expected to keep our foot rigid across there. You know, and that's kind of something impossible to do, especially in a real functional fighting situation. So however you get there, we do a cross step. We start to come back here. When you do this, this foot, yeah, extend the leg. That's the thing. He's going to fly over, wheel over. But if you have to wrap it, do so. Don't just stick it out there. Always point your toe, okay? But wrap it. If your leg is straight, fine. Or if you come in, some of you guys are coming in, they're coming in, and you want a rapid movement, that's fine too. You're still wheeling over your leg. That's the big thing. So whether you wrap it across it or keep it straight, whatever. Just remember, don't point your heel out. Point your toe, okay? So that's the big thing. Don't pose. Make it a natural, functional thing for you. And everybody's doing that. I just want to remind you to do that. So when you're coming in, you know, like I like to back step in across. You come across there, let's see, there's a slight cock in my leg. That's because I've done it that way for years and it works for me. If you have it straight, fine. But don't think you have to have it straight. And it's because that way it's kind of like rolling over a big log and you don't really work that well. Okay? All right, let's keep working. When you're doing the cross step, you want, instead of, you don't want to cross your feet, you don't want to do this, because it's weak, it's not as strong. When you're doing here, turn your hip. Immediately turn your hip into it, so you can immediately get the swing over and catch it. It's really a hip action as well. So if you just cross your feet, you never want to really cross your feet, because well, you're going to get slammed, right? So that's why. So when you're doing it here, if I like this grip here, and if I step in here, and then that allows me to pivot off that foot, come across. So if you're doing a cross step, don't do this. Do this. Step across, that covers that territory. Then you can cock your foot up, make your turn and sweep. Okay? Depends on how quick you are.
It'll be about a 2-7. So that's a good
way to put it, an actual turn. You know, that's a good standard way of doing it. I always like, my preference, guys, is lead. I like the opposite stance of my guy. I saw that a lot. You see a lot of right left. I'm a righty. He's a lefty. A lot of the situation. And see how, and you had a question earlier, Eric. How close is my foot? Pretty close. I don't want to be way out here. I want to be real close proximity to foot. Now this way, when I start to pull and set up, my back step is here. Okay? I've got a very quick back step across here, and that helps me turn, and my legs across. It's a real quick 1-2. So here's proximity of the foot, okay? Back step, quick back step, and across. And that's how quick you want it to be. Any way you get across the body, to get the Ogaruma. The Ogaruma is the finished product where you're wheeling them over your leg. Okay? That's the axis. And how you get there, when you do a cross step or some other setup, as long as you're on the outside of this line, that's one big difference that doesn't make it Hirai Goshi. The Hirai Goshi is on this, right? Well, this is more here and across. So that's where it's an Ogaruma. So it's a subtle difference, but it is a difference. It is a different movement entirely. It's a different throw entirely. Okay. All right. Now, can you finish without rolling? The only thing I'd say, Eric, can you finish without rolling over them? If you're doing the full Makakomi. If you can do that, let's see you try at least that one more time. I know Derek loves it, but you know. Yeah, there you go. Because you might want to follow up with an arm lock or something else. You know.
Yeah.